Yeah. Yeah. Yeah! Yeah!
My respects to you.
Take care now.
Look out.
Jesus Christ be praised. Do you know if there's anyone around here who could use my help?
Aye, there could be something for you. You're the blacksmith's son from Scarlet's, ain't you? The bailiff here could probably use you. He's got some jobs for the Scarlet's refugees, but he's not sure who's good for what. He was moaning about it here yesterday.
Have you got a bed for the night?
Certainly. For how long?
Just the one night.
Sure, but let's see your coin first. These are harsh times.
That's quite a lot. Can we discuss the price? Agree?
Well, now, a little more and we'll shake on it. You'll like it here. Like sleeping on a cloud it is.
Where do I go to sleep?
On the upper floor of the inn. There's steps up to it outside. Your chamber is the one in the middle. God be with you.
Chance of a bite.
Good evening.
Here.
Goodbye.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Judging by that ugly gob, you must be Henry.
What do you want with me?
Miller Peshek described you in detail, and he was also pretty clear about what we should do to you to jog your memory.
Huh? I don't understand.
They nursed you back to health at the mill, and somebody had to pay for it. Or have you hit your head again and can't even remember that? Well, don't worry. We know it's you.
I don't have the money on me. Can Peshek wait a few more days? I'll pay everything back.
He can wait for a little while. But you'd better watch it, because next time you'll take a beating.
I feel quite hungry.
Watch what you're doing! There's people walking here!
Yeah!
Ride a horse, idiot!
Yeah!
Debts must be paid, boy. And if they aren't, you know how the story goes.
I don't have the money on me. Can Peshek wait a few more days? I'll pay everything back.
More time? Are you joking? How about I smash your mouth in as a little reminder you should pay on time?
What the hell was that?
Well, lad. Yeah!
Take that!
You'll get what?
I'll slay you, you scum!
Who's there?
Good morning. Good luck, then.
Come on up and take a look.
Jesus Christ be praised.
May the Lord watch over you.
Let's have a word about the price.
Sure, why not?
Since it's you.
Well, a little more and we'll call it a deal. Aye, for that amount I can be persuaded.
God be with you.
Good luck to you. Farewell.
Let's have a word about the price.
Aye.
What do you say to this?
I'd almost shake on that. Almost.
My last offer.
Well, a little more and we'll call it a deal.
I knew we'd come to an arrangement.
Good day to you. What do you need?
Good luck to you.
Good morning.
Thank you.
Let's have a word about the price.
Aye.
What do you say to this?
I'd almost shake on that. Almost. All right, so.
My respects to you. Good luck to you. Good day to you.
May the Lord watch over you.
Let's talk about the price.
Naturally.
What about this?
Well, a little more, and we'll call it a deal.
All right. And now?
That's not enough.
That's a sum I can live with.
Thank you.
Yeah.
God be with you. Do you need anything? Goodbye. Good day to you. What do you need?
I'd like to order something here.
So what are you interested in?
Get myself fixed up a bit. Have a bath and get my clothes washed.
But of course. Money first, though.
I'm not giving you that much.
And how much are you willing to pay?
Since it's you.
That's not enough. You won't regret spending the money. I guarantee it. May the Lord... Take care.
Yeah.
I've got the money to pay that debt.
And I was afraid you had a chamber pot for a head. Hand it over. That job's still going, if you're interested.
I'm not interested. Tell me something about yourself.
There's nothing much to tell. I was born at the mill. I live here, and I'll surely die here. But before I do, I've plenty of work to do, and I hope I live to see peace in this land again.
Can you tell me something about the other millers?
There's a couple of other fellows around here in my trade. Woodsek in Kohelnitz and Simon in Sasa.
Tell me about Woodsek.
He's young and hot-blooded, with a short temper. But he's a fine fellow when you get to know him. His heart's in the right place, and he's always willing to lend a helping hand. Unfortunately, he got himself into a feud with that usurer, the merchant Wolfram Pruder. A slimy bastard he is. And now they're sworn enemies.
What about this Simon in Sassau?
An odd one he is, a loner who don't talk much. But he's as dogged as a hunting hound once he gets his teeth into anything. He won't let go until he sees it through, even if he has to walk over dead bodies.
Can you tell me... Do you know Sir Bernard, the rat-eye captain?
He's a grumpy bastard, but fair, I'd say.
What's Sir Hans Capon like?
Ah, that worthless dandy. Sir Hanish has to knock some sense into him, or I dread to think what will become of this place when he takes over.
What's the local lord like?
Sir Hanush? He treats his people well, but he's tough as an old oak. The way things are these days, I wouldn't wonder if he and his men started kicking some asses.
That's all.
Sure. Farewell.
Well, you're a sight for sore eyes.
I'd like to take Mutt traveling with me again.
I see he came back on his own. Did you do something to him?
No.
You haven't been taking care of him.
I have. He just got very dangerous, and I didn't want anything to happen to him. So I sent him back here, where he'd be safe.
Ah. That was kind of you. Sorry.
Now I can take him again. Come here, Mutt.
Dark at home? A torch will help.
Good morning.
Let's talk about the price.
Well, we can try it.
What about this?
Come now. Just a little more, and we have a deal. All right, sir.
Look what I've got for you. You'll love this.
Thank you.
My respects to you.
About that debt.
Here you are.
Thank you. I'm glad to see you're a man of honour. Is there anything else I can do for you?
Good luck to you.
Vegetables! Fresh vegetables!
Raw for the winter!
Good health to you. Farewell.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, lad! Don't you want a little wager on the rat-aid tourney?
That job you wanted me to do, I won't do it. I pay both you and the apothecary, so we're even.
You're an ungrateful pup, aren't you? Well, suit yourself. If you ever need anything, you know where not to go. Farewell.
God be with you.
My respects to you.
You've an honest trade. How come you got mixed up in crime?
Evil times. The harvest failed, and there was no grain to mill, and a child to feed on top of it all. I had no choice. And meanwhile, the lords in the castle and the monks in the monastery stuffed their craws to bursting. Where's the justice in that?
So you took justice into your own hands, is that it? And now you take whatever you need?
Pull your head out of your arse, Henry, and take a good look around you. Wars come and go, but nothing really changes. It's the poor that do the dying, and the nobles who reap the rewards. We have to survive somehow, so why concern ourselves with morals? May the Lord watch over you.
Henry. I'm so glad to see you.
I've brought you something.
Oh, Hal. Is this for me? This must have cost you a fortune. But I like it very much, thank you. You really mustn't bring me any more gifts like that, or you'll spoil me.
What now? Shall we take a walk?
You don't give up, do you? Well, let me think. And where would you care to go?
What if we took a stroll along the river?
Why not? That sounds lovely. Shall we go?
Let's go.
That was a good idea to go for a walk. Not that I don't like the mill, but you get tired of it, so I'm glad you took me out. I'd love to see the markets in Prague one day. Have you ever been to Prague?
No, I haven't. I have been in Kuttenberg, but Prague must be much bigger.
I've heard it's pretty smelly, though.
Yeah, so many people in one place. So many assholes.
That's disgusting. I'd love to listen to that young preacher, Jan Hus. They say he preaches in the common tongue. Everyone's talking about it.
I bet he's just handsome. That's why the women dote on him.
You're a right one. A preacher doesn't need good looks for people to listen to him.
And what about that fine fellow at St. James? I know full well why all the girls have started going to confession, and you have too, so don't give me any of that.
You scoundrel. Well, all right. I admit I find him handsome. But that doesn't make me a bad Christian.
I'd never dare to suggest such a thing.
Tell you what. Let's not dawdle. Last one is a slimy slug. Look out.
I'll have to get something to eat. I'm starting to get hungry.
Sit down here next to me, Hal. And what about you? I heard you're helping Sir Radzig.
Sir Radzig has me running in a few errands. I have to say, he always treats me well, and I make a wage.
So you've had your turn of luck. What's it like serving nobility?
It's endless luxury, money, banquets, games stuffed with other games.
A chicken stuffed with a frog?
Yeah, and that's nothing compared to a frog stuffed with a chicken.
A goat stuffed...
with a pig?
Ha, ha, ha.
Now then.
Oh, Henry, what am I going to do with you? Wandering the land, turning innocent girls' heads.
The only one here whose head is all messed up is me. How do you always manage to look so good?
Just look at the lady killer. Where did you learn to talk that way?
I don't recall which church service it was exactly.
You scoundrel. But you certainly know how to make a girl feel special.
You may continue. But now I have to go.
Can I go with you?
Just a little way.
I don't want anyone to gossip.
Thank you for coming with me. Please come and see me again.
Yeah!
Handy implements and machines of every kind.
Good health to you.
Farewell.
I'd like to discuss the price.
Sure, why not?
Satisfied?
Well, now a little more and we'll shake on it. Aye, that would do it.
Yeah.
I'd like to train a bit, just lightly, with practice weapons.
Right. Let's get to it. What weapon would you like to try? I've got a bastard sword, a short sword. We can fight with poles. Whatever you fancy.
I still don't feel entirely competent with the bastard sword. I'd like to try that.
Right, lad. Grab your piece, and we'll get stuck in.
I'll have you. I'll have you.
Ow.
the matter? Come on! Yeah. This one ends.
Thank you. day to you. May the Lord watch over you.
Good day to you. What do you need?
How are you coping?
As well as we can, Henry. You can be glad Sir Radzik took you into his service. I hear you even go hunting with Lord Capon.
I've been once. And I don't think it'll be happening again anytime soon.
Ah, it's a shame. Because I was going to ask a favor of you. I'm sure you know there's a lot of hungry mouths here, so I thought you might be able to help.
I don't know. I'm not such a great hunter that I could feed all the refugees.
No, that's not what I meant. It's the townspeople here who have a taste for game. They want to live like the nobility, see? A few of the burghers have been to see me already, to ask if we'd try our luck in the woods. They promised us supplies in exchange. Flour, lard, eggs, and the like. But we can't afford to take the risk of poaching. We're barely tolerated as it is. If one of ours got caught in the woods, they'd hang him from the nearest tree. But I was thinking, you're in Sir Radzik's garrison, and you go hunting with Sir Hans. You could help us.
Well, I got away with brawling with Lord Capon, so I don't suppose they'll string me up for a few hares.
Great, Henry. I really appreciate it. The local tailor was asking me about getting some hares to put on a feast for a visiting merchant.
All right. I'll bring you something.
Thank you. You'll be saving us from starvation.
May the Lord watch over you. My respects to you.
Let's fight.
I told you, don't come back to me till you've beaten Stephen and Ringlet. Got it? Take care now.
Good health to you.
Aren't you Ringlet? Milan says I have to beat you before he'll take me on.
And you're that blacksmith's lad, right? What do you want out of it? You're not living in the dirt here like the rest of us.
Maybe not. But why shouldn't I try and beat some coin out of him too?
Yeah, and you can pass it on to us that need it. If you want to fight me, you dandy, then pay up or fuck off.
Good luck to you.
Here. No pay for
God be with you.
My respects to you. Good luck to you.
I wouldn't beg, good neighbors, but I'm reduced to this.
Fresh bread! Bread! Rolls, buns, and pretzels for you!
Cucumbers! Lovely cucumbers! Asparagus and prunes!
Mother of God, you look like you've been assaulted.
God bless.
Good day to you. What do you need?
May the Lord watch over you.
Thank you.
address.
Farewell.
Good afternoon. May the Lord watch over you.
What are you doing here?
Is something the matter?
Look out. Greetings. What do you need?
Take care now.
You! What the hell are you fooling about here for?
Are you looking for me? Hey, who's there?
God bless you. What troubles you?
How goes it, sir? Are you recovered?
I am, for all the good it does. The boredom here. The only thing I have to read is the Bible. And the Hanush won't let anyone near me but the priest. Have you any idea the monotonous drivel that fella comes out with?
This world is but a trial. Be repentant.
He talks to me as if I'm about to breathe my last.
Actually, talks to me as if I were already dead.
Listen, Henry, won't you come with me to the Ratte Baths? I need a change of scene before moss starts growing on me.
Why to the baths?
Well, a hot bath does a man good.
It does. Which is why you can bath here any time you like.
Have you ever seen Clara, the bathhouse wench? Henry, she's a beauty. If I didn't know better, I'd say I was in love with her.
How much time do you want to spend there?
I don't know yet, but at least a few days. Bathing in mud wraps during the day and in the evening. In the evening, fun. What'd you say? Will you join me?
But what about your wound, sir?
Well, I won't lie to you. It hurts like the devil. But I'd rather hobble along with a cane, howling in pain, than listen to a selection of the most boring passages from the Gospels for one more minute.
Why not? When do you want to go?
I shall go there right away, but wait until at least dusk to join me. I'll have company there.
All right, I'll come and join you there.
Good luck, then.
Good boy. That's my boy. Look what I've got for you. You'll love this.
I'll be with you.
Let's fight.
Have you got coin? I already told you I won't fight for the fun of it.
Good luck to you.
Jesus Christ, your clothes. Were you assaulted? Damn bandits. May they burn in hell. Good luck, then.
Thank you.
Yeah! Yeah!
I think I've mastered the basics of combat. Could you teach me something a bit more advanced?
I see. And what weapon are you such a master at?
I'm pretty good with a sword.
You're a bit cocky, ain't you? All right then, let's see what you can do. If you're as good as you think you are, I'll teach you some master strikes.
I'm ready.
Take your weapon and fight. If you look like you know what you're doing, I'll teach you a trick or two. Ow. Bad. All right, it seems you're ready for the next lesson. Now, pay close attention. I'll teach you the most important thing. It's good to be able to attack, it's good to be able to fend off your opponent's blows.
The best is when you're able to do both at once. A master stroke is when you parry your opponent's blow and strike him at the same time. Attack me, and I'll show you how it's done.
See? I parry and strike in one move. There's no defense against this technique if it's executed well. The thing is to time it right. Block right into your opponent's strike and match your movement to his. One elegant technique and the fight is won. Try it. I'll attack slowly. You parry. Nice.
Thank you.
God be with you.
Let's fight.
You gave those two a pretty good hiding, and I made a groschen or two in bets. You Scallets fellows are good for my purse. Take care now. Ah!
God!
Goods, handy implements, and machines of every kind. Come on up and buy.
God be with you. What can I do for you?
May the Lord watch over you.
I'd like to discuss the price.
Aye.
Is this enough?
I'd almost shake on that. Almost.
Ah, you're flaying me here.
Well, a little more and we'll shake on it.
That's a sum I can live with.
Look what I've got for you. You'll love this.
Greetings. What do you need?
May the Lord watch over you.
I'd like to discuss the price.
Why not?
Satisfied?
That's not enough. All right, so. Come get them.
Dear people, don't leave a poor woman to starve. Sigismund took everything I had.
Rakes, spades, forks, and axes. All you need to pay mother.
Bread, fresh bread.
With salt, caraway seeds, garlic, and more. You'll find it nowhere else.
Hey! What else you, sir?
May the Lord watch over you.
Huh. Onions that'll even make your man cry like a little lass. Come and buy some.
My respects to you.
Come and get it. Man cannot live by bread alone.
May the Lord watch over you.
I'd like to discuss the price.
Aye.
Is this enough?
Well now, a little more and we'll shake on it. Finally, a reasonable sum.
You come there.
I'm reduced to this. I'm from Scarlet and, well...
Good health to you. Good luck to you.
Dark at home? A torch will help. Your fields lie fallow? Here's a hoe. Need straw for the winter? Then you'll need a rake.
Jesus Christ be praised.
Have you heard anything about the Cumans in Sigismund's army?
I don't know if it's just old wives' tales, but I hear truly terrible things.
How do the Ratai folk get on with the refugees?
Ha! Don't even talk to me about it. I wish that rabble was gone. I know they've met with misfortune, but here they do nothing but thieve and make problems.
Take care now.
Cucumbers, lovely cucumbers, asparagus and prunes.
Cheery, aren't we? With salt, caraway seeds, garlic and more. You'll find it nowhere else.
Kettles for water, baskets for goods, and torches for the night.
Greetings.
Ah, God Almighty! Can't you see there's people here? That horse of yours nearly trampled me to death.
Did I tell you about my wife's lace making?
No, I didn't know she did that.
She only started not long ago. Always in the evening while there's still a bit of light. She sits down and gets on with it. And she's quite deft at it by now.
I'm not surprised. Betty was always good with her hands.
You're right there. Anyway, I showed a couple of pieces she made last night to old Tonda from Tabor, one of my goods from. He said, right away, you take them. And how much do I want for them?
Well, now.
I was surprised myself. But I wasn't sure Betty would even want to sell them. So I asked for a high price. and he says, that's fine. I started counting out the coin there and then.
Just like that? Since I heard about him, he's a right skinflint.
Slunk off right after all the slaughter, and God alone knows where he got to. What's that but a guilty conscience?
I don't know, well, but that don't sound much like him. Maybe they just nabbed him.
That crossed my mind too, but I reckon not.
Those bastards that raided the farm were bloodthirsty cutthroats who spared nobody they got their hands on. By all accounts, it wasn't coin they were after, only blood. Why would they kidnap some stable hand?
True enough, but it still don't make sense to me. Why would a quiet lad like that throw his lot in with that spawn of Satan? For sure there's something else behind it.
I don't know about that.
Huh? God be with you.
Good luck to you.
Yeah!
Take care of them.
answer me.
Hey, you there. You gonna hang around here gaping like a stuffed squirrel all day and night? If you can't pay for a bath,
hey, what
off.
Do you think you're doing? Get the lost on. Jesus Christ! Your clothes! Were you assaulted? Damn bandits, may they burn in hell! Take care.
Clean your body and lighten your soul. You should come more often.
Paying guests, not idlers, with nothing better to do.
Can I help?
What do you need, sir?
I need you to do me a favor, Henry.
What, again?
Now, what's your tone, peasant? You'd never think it, but Zdena here is a demon at dice. She stripped me bare-ass naked, and I couldn't even get a ribbon off her.
So it didn't quite go as planned?
Not quite, but maybe you can do better. Right then, you've got to beat Zdena at dice. I refuse to be the only one here with his arse on show.
All right. Why the hell not?
How have you all been getting on here?
Well, Lord Capon's been chasing us around a bit and so forth. Nothing we're not used to.
How about a game of dice, then?
Are you sure? What would I do with two naked men here?
Let's see how good you are.
May the Lord watch over. So, let's see what you can do.
Thank you.
You haven't exactly gotten off to a good start, have you? You'd have more luck if you'd remembered to throw the other dice.
This'll be the one. Cursed luck!
It seems there's method in your madness.
Should I? Shouldn't I? No, I daren't. Competition at last.
You know I'll let you win, of course. You know, there's a thin line between caution and cowardice.
Huh. That's it. Now you.
Are you afraid of wearing the spots on? Oh no!
Bad luck, gentlemen. I suppose now you'll want me to strip as well to keep you company.
Well, now that you mention it.
Sorry to disappoint you. I have to sleep sometime too.
I could do with a good soak too.
Then strip off and hop in here.
All right, why not?
Put your clothes in the trunk.
Shift over. I don't want to tread on anything vital.
All right, give me a moment and I'll roll it up again.
Oh, that feels good.
Now, don't take this personally, but I've never seen a man more in need of a wash. I've known cowpats less fragrant.
You certainly know how to have a good time.
Here, yeah, drink. It's not terribly high quality, but it should do the job.
I don't mind if I do. Give me that.
That's the spirit.
So this is how you recuperate from your injuries? Booze and wenches?
Of course. Is there any other way? So, what news, Henry?
Never mind about me. What about you? Have you recovered from our hunting adventure?
I'm well enough, Henry. These baths are just the thing, and Zdena here is very healing.
Clara! Bring some wine for the gents before they get cross.
You know what, Henry? We really can't drink this local piss.
Really, sir? Such mean words from a noble gent.
Clara! My most favouritest bath maid. But admit it, my dear. The wine you have here is pitiful.
What's wrong with the bathhouse wine?
I'd rather drink the bath water. You should go and get something better. Though, where? Ah! I know! In the cellars under the rat's house, there's some excellent wine that Sir Hanush bought for us.
And you want me to go there and get it now?
I'd be indebted to you. And a grateful nobleman is the best ally you can have.
Sorry, but I really don't have time for this now. Can't you just make do with the bathhouse wine?
Absolutely not. I will have my Sylvan Red from that cellar, even if it takes you a week to get it. We'll find some way of entertaining ourselves in the meantime.
I'd like to ask you something about this wine.
What is it?
So I can just go there and take whatever I want?
Yeah. No, not exactly. It would be best if no one saw you.
Ah, I see. And this wine wouldn't be kept under lock and key by any chance?
Yes, probably. But that won't stop a clever fella like you, will it?
Which wine is it you want?
The Sylvan Red. It's the very last keg on the right at the back. You'll recognise it easily. It's the only one that's tapped.
All right. All right, then. I'll bring it.
Good man.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'll have to get something to eat. I'm starting to get hungry.
Huh?
Hey, you! What are you doing here?
Lord Capon sent me to get some wine for him.
Lord Capon, eh? A likely story.
You clearly don't know Lord Capon. Do you think he's going to leave in the middle of his merriment to go and get his own wine?
Ha! No, that doesn't sound like the young lord. I suppose he sent you for the Sylvan Red.
The very one.
Well, you'll leave some for Sir Hanush at least, won't you?
I'll try.
not that bad. I woke up with a rat in my blanket. A rat.
Yeah.
So, about that wine you sent me for.
Well, have you got it?
Of course.
You really broke into the cellar at the rat house?
I certainly did. I hope that wine's really worth the trouble I had.
I don't believe it. You really broke into the cellar. You're insane.
But, sir, you asked me to do it.
Jesus, Henry! Be talked into just about anything.
Well, let's see if this wine is as good as you say.
What are you waiting for? The parish priest's blessing? Come on then, get it down you. Ah, now that's what I call a real wine. Silver red. It's not like that donkey's piss they serve in this otherwise delightful establishment. You can tell from the first sip, can't you, Henry?
Yeah, as you say, sir. Silver and red. The taste is unmistakable.
The other girls.
I know, Clara. You are different. you deserve more.
Mm.
You deserve flowers.
What?
What kind of flowers do you like?
Well, I like all kinds. I like dandelions, sage, knotweed, and poppies. I really like poppies.
Oh, Henry, did you hear that?
What? The lady requests dandelions, sage, cabbages. That's not right.
No, knotweed and poppies.
What? You want me to go flower picking now?
I know, I'm putting you to work again. But if you do it, I'll give you scrivency flopping groschen.
So, that much? All right, I'll go.
What was it she said? Sage something, something else, and roses?
Yeah, what would a bouquet be without roses?
There's some in the upper castle garden.
Yeah.
Thank you.
are you doing here? I'd like some privacy, if you don't mind.
I've come for my wench.
Well, as you can see, I'm not your wench or anyone else's, so fuck off.
What are you doing with my Clara, you cunt?
Archie, stop that. He's just bathing here.
Bathing here, is he? With all the wenches but you, a whores.
Archie!
What are you whoring now, too?
That's enough, Archibald!
Archibald?
You shut your mouth, I'm not done with you!
No, I swear, the gentleman hasn't touched me.
Actually, that's quite true. Well, mostly.
No, nothing happened, nothing.
We can talk about this later. First, I'm dealing with this bastard!
I'd like to see you try, arse and balls. Arse and balls!
Love of God, stop it, both of you!
Fucking hell. Hey. What do you think you're doing?
You're done for, fucker!
Fuck, Henry!
You're gonna cry now! Oh! Shit!
What the hell got into you? Trying to drown a nobleman?
Oh, shit. Fuck. I didn't know.
Get out of my sight. Go on before I remember I can have you hung.
I apologize, your lordship. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Archie, wait. Oh.
Phew. I nearly got drowned by arson balls.
Oh. That's the least relaxing bath I've ever had.
Fuck, I feel like I've swallowed the Baltic.
Oh, drinking will be the death of you.
Damn right. Is there any wine left?
Are you out of your fucking mind? You want to carry on?
Of course. Well, don't tell me you don't fancy a drink after all that.
Want something?
What will you do with them, Sir Hans?
What, with arson balls? I don't know. What do you think I should do with him?
He was drunk and insane with jealousy. I'm sure he'll be sorry when he sobers up.
But he tried to drown a nobleman! I can't just let him off.
He didn't know who you were. Anyway, if you let him off, you'll show that you're the better man.
I suppose you're right. Fuck him. But we had some pretty good sport, eh?
Good luck then.